Good evening children, this is Padma from GK Jain Schools. Today we are going to start with the integral calculus from 12th business maths. Let us see about the concepts and methods of integrations. Let's move on to the topic children. Now let's see the basics of integration. First we'll see concept of indefinite integral. In differential calculus we have learned how to calculate the differential coefficient f dash of x with respect to x. In this chapter we have to find out the primitive function f of x, that is the original function whenever it is the derived function f dash of x. That is, in short, integration is the reverse process of differentiation. For example, if it is d by dx of sin x is equal to cos x, cos x is the derived function and sin x is the primitive function. Now we'll see one more definition. A function f of x, capital F of x, is said to be primitive function. That is, capital F of x stands for the differentiation and the answer, that is, while differentiating it once again we'll get the integration, that is small f of x. And in general we have these rules. Now remarks: if two different primitive functions f of x and g of x have the same derived function, they differ only by a constant term. Integral f of x dx is called as indefinite integral. The symbol looks like an elongated s, that is, they are defining about the symbol. Integral f of x dx is read as integral of f of x with respect to x. So these are the remarks that we need to go through before entering into the sums. Now two important properties of integral calculus. If you are having a constant along with the function, that is x is there and along with it 2 is there, means you can write 2 as it is outside the integral symbol. That is, 2x is there means you can write the 2 outside the integral symbol, integrate the x and then you can write it together. Similarly, f of x and g of x are combined with the plus or minus sign, means you can split it along with the integrals also. Now we'll see the methods. There are 4 methods: integration by decomposition, integration by parts, integration by substitution, integration by successive reduction. First we'll be seeing about integration by decomposition. Now we'll see the types. First we are going to see type 1, the standard results of integration. This is the very first formula, very important formula: integral x power n dx is equal to x power n plus 1 by n plus 1 plus c, where n is not equal to minus 1 and c is the integration constant. Second one, integral ax plus b the whole power n dx is equal to ax plus b the whole power n plus 1 by a into n plus 1 plus c, where n is not equal to minus 1. So this is how we have to do the sums using these formulas. And we have few more formulas. These formulas we'll be using in the sums. Integral dx is equal to x plus c. Remember, in differentiation when we differentiate a constant we'll get 0, but it is totally different in integration. When we differentiate it we'll get x. So these formulas we have to go through before doing the sums. Now we'll move on to the example sums. So now we'll see few example sums involving the two concepts of type 1. Okay, so first, the very first formula is integral x power n dx is equal to x power n plus 1 by n plus 1 plus c, where c is the integration constant. Okay, so now I'll write this ax square plus bx plus c divided by this root x can be written as x power 1 by 2 into dx. Okay, so which is equal to ax square plus bx plus c into this x power 1 by 2. When it is taken to the numerator, this will become x power minus 1 by 2 into dx. Now multiplying this x power minus 1 by 2 inside, this will become a x power 2 into x power minus 1 by 2 plus bx into x power minus 1 by 2 plus c into x power minus 1 by 2 dx. Okay, now see, integral a, base or same, powers can be added. So add the powers, x power 2 minus 1 by 2 plus b, here also base or same, powers can be added, 1 minus 1 by 2 plus c, x power minus 1 by 2 into dx. So integral a x power, if I am going to take the LCM, 2 into 2 is 4, 4 minus 1 is 3 by 2, plus b x power 2, so 2 minus 1 is 1 by 2, plus c x power minus 1 by 2
dx.
Now, we saw in another formula, like we can take the constant outside. So, this will become a integral x power 3 by 2 dx. I am splitting the integrals. Plus b integral x power 1 by 2 dx. Plus c integral x power minus 1 by 2 dx. Now, I will apply this formula x power n dx is equal to x power n plus 1 by n plus 1 plus c formula for all these terms individually. So, this will become a into x power 3 by 2 plus 1 by 3 by 2 plus 1. Okay. Plus b into x power 1 by 2 plus 1 by 1 by 2 plus 1 plus c into x power minus 1 by 2 plus 1 by minus 1 by 2 plus 1 plus constant c. After integrating, we have to mention the constant c. Already we are having a variable c here, so we'll make the constant as k. Okay. So, this is how you have to integrate step by step. After this, we have to simplify this. So, how will you simplify this? This will become x power 3 by 2 plus 1. If I am going to take the LCM again, this will become 3 by 2 plus this will be 2. So, 5 by 2. So, this will be is equal to a into x power 5 by 2 by 5 by 2 plus b into x power 3 by 2 by 3 by 2 plus c into x power 1 by 2 by 1 by 2 plus k, which is equal to, again we can take this 5 by 2 to the numerator, so this will become 2a x power 5 by 2 by 5 plus 2b x power 3 by 2 by 3 plus 2c x power 1 by 2, because here already we are having only 2 plus k. So this is how you have to integrate. So we will see next sum using the type 2 formula. Evaluate integral root of 2x plus 1 into dx. So what is the type 2 formula? Integral ax plus b the whole power n into dx. The formula is ax plus b the whole power n plus 1 by a into n plus 1 plus c. So, this is the formula. So, instead of ax plus b, we are having root of 2x plus 1. Means, this integral root of 2x plus 1 dx can be written as integral. This root can be written as 2x plus 1 the whole power 1 by 2 dx. So, instead of ax plus b, we are having 2x plus 1. Instead of n, we are having 1 by 2. Now, substitute as per the formula. So, this will be 2x plus 1 the whole power 1 by 2 plus 1 divided by, instead of a, what is the number we are having here? 2. So, 2 into again 1 by 2 plus 1 plus constant is c. So, this will be 2x plus 1 the whole power, if you take LCM here also 2. So, it will be 3 by 2 divided by 2 into again 3 by 2 plus constant is c. Now, 2 and 2 will get cancelled. So, the answer is 2x plus 1 the whole power 3 by 2 by 3 plus c. So, this is how you have to use the type 2 formula. This is how we have to use and get the answer. This is how we have to integrate. So, now we will see type 2 integral of 1 by x dx. The formula is log x plus c. And then integral of 1 by ax plus b dx is 1 by a into log ax plus b plus c. We'll see few example sums in this model. So, we will see example 2.9. Evaluate integral 3x square plus 2x plus 1 divided by x into dx. So, for this, we'll use type 1 formula. What is the type 1 formula? That is type 2 first formula. That is 1 by x dx is equal to log x plus c. So, we'll bring this expression to this format. So, 3x square by x plus 2x by x plus 1 by x into dx, okay, is equal to integral x square and x gets cancelled, means this will become 3x plus x and x gets cancelled, means this will become 2, and this is 1 by x dx. Now we saw in one of the property that we can split and write the integrals. So this will become integral 3x dx plus integral 2 dx plus integral 1 by x dx, which is equal to, again in one of the property we saw that we can take this 3 outside. So this will become integral x dx plus 2 also we can take outside dx plus integral 1 by x dx. So what is integration of x? X power 1. So 1 means 1 plus 1 by 1 plus 1. So this will become 3x square by 2 plus differentiating this, I mean integrating this dx will become 2x plus, and this is the type 2 first formula, that is log x plus c. So this is the answer. This is how you have to integrate the sum using type 2 formulas. So we'll see type 2 second formula, that is integral 1 by ax plus b dx can be written as 1 by a log of ax plus b plus c. So comparing this with this, this 2 is a constant, so you can take it outside. So this will become 2 integral dx by 3x plus 5, which is equal to, so I can now take the, after taking the 2 outside, I can now integrate this integral dx by 3x plus 5. So which is equal to, first I have to write 1 by a. So what is a here? What is the coefficient of x? 3. So this will be 1 by 3 log, write the full expression. What is that? 3x plus 5 plus c. So 2 into 1 by 3 is 2 by 3 log 3x plus 5 plus c. So this is how we have to integrate the sums using type 2 second method. So children, in today's class we came to know about the concepts and methods involved in integration. In tomorrow's class we'll be moving on to the exercise, children. Thank you.